Good group. Thank you for joining us. That's nice. Thank you for joining us at home for Card Sharks. That's great. On our first show, to have a nice group like this down in the studio audience. Card Sharks, a game of decisions where you can win a fortune on the turn of a single card. Now let's get to the cards. Janice and Ann, if you will, start loading in the cards. The red cards on the top will be played by one player. The blue cards on the bottom will be played by another. And now let's meet our very first two card sharks. Hello there, Susan.
Hello.
Riley.
Hello.
Nice to have you here with us.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Tell us something about yourself.
I'm an unemployed elementary school teacher. I moved out here 2 months ago from Philadelphia, and I'm looking for a job.
Oh, well, listen, if there's anybody out there looking for a night, you're unemployed just because you just got here, right?
Right.
You're a good teacher.
Excellent.
Okay, now we got the commercial in. We'll say hello to Mark O'Connor. Hello,
Jim,
Mark, welcome.
Nice to have you here.
Yeah. What about you?
Well, I'm a pre-medical student at the greatest university in the world. That's the University of Southern California. All right.
not too many out there, Mark.
Come on. I'm a USC Yale leader, and I work in a hospital emergency room.
That's terrific. And you're single?
Yes, I am.
Susan, are you single?
Yes, I am.
Susan, this is Mark. Mark, this is
good
luck to both of you with the game. And each player has their own deck of 52 playing cards. They've been shuffled and cut in front of the players before we go on the air. The red cards on the top will be played by Susan. The lower cards, the blue cards, will be played by Mark. Now, players, the object of the game is to work your way across the board, predicting whether each of these cards is higher or lower than the one that precedes it. Before we can begin calling high-low with the cards, you have to first answer a high-low toss-up question. Here comes my own little R2-D2 around here right now. All of our toss-up questions are based on a poll of 100 people, and they test your ability to judge human nature. And our first question, which goes to you, Susan, we polled 100 college students. We asked 100 college students from the UCLA campus, not USC, UCLA, are you in love at the moment? How many said they were, Susan?
This was students, not...
Students, yes. College students at UCLA.
Oh, I think most college students have been in love at one time or another. I'm going to say...
How many are in love right now?
Right now. I'm going to say 64 students.
Mark, she says 64 students are in love at the moment. Do you think the actual number is higher or lower?
All USC students are great lovers. UCLA, I'll have to say higher.
You say higher?
Yes.
All right. You think they're in love. Isn't that nice?
Yes.
If they are higher, you go to the board first, Mark. If it's not higher, then Susan gets first crack at the cards. And I'll find out as you do. The actual number of college students who said they were in love is 46. It's not higher, it's lower. Susan, you get the first look at your base card. You answer the high-low toss-up, so you have the right to change this if you'd like. You have a 5. Do you want to play that 5 or do you want to change it?
I'm going to change it.
You'll change it. Here comes the next card off the top of your deck. Let's hope it's a better one for you. It is a 4. Yeah, that's
a little bit better.
Is this next card higher or lower than that 4?
I'm going to call this card higher.
Higher than a 4. Remember, if it's another 4 you lose, it must be higher. And it is a 7. That's higher.
Okay.
Susan, at this point, you can freeze and protect your position, or you can continue calling high-low all the way across the board. But if you make a miscall, you lose all of your cards back to your original base card, and Mark gets a free chance at his cards. What's it going to be? You going to freeze or are you going to continue?
I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze it right there. We move this... base over. That's your new base card. We can't take that away from you, and you've kept Mark away from his cards. The first player to get to the end of the board wins the game in $100. We play the best 2 out of 3. The winner of the match gets a crack at the money cards and a possible win of over $28,000. Here's the next high-low toss-up, and it goes to you this time, Mark. We asked 100 women in the audience of the Carol Burnett Show, would you be turned on by a nude centerfold of the Fonz? How many said yes?
The Fonz.
Yes.
I'll have to say 35 women.
35. I wonder if that's with or without the motorcycle.
Yeah.
Susan, higher or lower than 35?
I'm going to say higher.
You say higher.
I'm going to say higher. He's pretty popular.
He's pretty popular.
Yeah.
Let's find out. The actual number of women who said they would be turned on by a nude picture of the Fonz is 14. It's not higher.
Right.
It's lower. Well, the Fonz didn't do so well on that, but Mark did very well. He gets a look at his base card, which is a 3. Good card. You want to play that?
Jim, I'm going to play. Next card, higher, please.
Higher than a 3. It is a four. Ooh, just a little bit higher. Same options apply. You can freeze at any time, or you can continue and risk the cards.
Jim, I got a gamble. Go on. Next card, higher, please.
Higher than a four. It is a six. Getting a little more dangerous now. You're getting near those middle cards, and you have two cards to protect. What's it going to be?
I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze it right there. All right. Now you've got a one-card lead on Susan as that becomes your new base card. The next question goes to you, Susan. We asked 100 secretaries in Los Angeles, do you know something about your boss that could get him in trouble with his wife? How many said they did? I told you we were going to test your ability to judge human nature.
I've never been a secretary, but from what I've heard, I would say probably 52.
52. Mark, higher or lower? The audience thinks higher. What do you think?
Susan, I've got to say lower. Lower.
Lower. All right. The actual number of secretaries who said they knew something about their boss that would get him in trouble with his wife is 38. It's lower. See that? So, ladies, if you're out there and your husband says he's working late at the office, he probably is, according to our poll. Mark, you like this six? You want to change it?
I'd like to change it, please.
Here's the next card off the top of the deck. It is a two. Great card.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Call this next one, Mark.
Jim, next card, higher.
Only a two would lose for you. Higher than a two, it is a six. Ooh. Well, you're near the middle again, but you need only one card to win the game. What's it going to be?
I'm going to go on.
You're going to risk it.
And I'm going to say it's higher, please.
All right, you're risking both of these cards, but if this is higher than a six, you have the first game of the match. It is an eight.
Yeah,
you did it, Mark. Yeah. Game number one to Mark. He's got $100. The next game coming up in just a moment. Janice will clear the board. We'll be back for that right after this. Please watch. Good job, Mark.
Thank you.
And we are back. Mark is the first game of the match and $100. Janice, if you'll deal out the cards for the next game, same decks of cards. Janice will fill them in. We'll start the next game, and this time the question goes to you, Mark, as we left off. We asked 100 women in a California studio audience, have you ever received an obscene phone call? How many said yes, they have? Tough question.
Yeah. I have to say 65 women received obscene phone calls.
You say 65. Ooh, the audience didn't agree with that too much. Higher or lower, Susan?
I'm going to say higher.
You'll say higher?
Yeah, I think more.
Oh, I would have thought lower, and I don't know the answer either. The actual number of women who said they have received an obscene phone call is 75. It is higher. There are people out there on the phone we don't know about. Yes, it is higher, and Susan gets the first look at the cards. Here's your base card for this game, Susan. It is a seven. Do you want to play that or change it?
I wish to change it, Jim, please.
And here's the next card off the top of the deck. It is a five. That's a better card. Call this one.
I'm going to call the next card higher.
Higher than a five? It is an ace. Very much higher. Susan, as always, you can freeze to continue, but you've got a great card.
Yes, I'll continue. Next card lower, please.
Lower than an ace. It is a six. Getting around that middle now, Susan. What's it going to be?
I think I'll freeze.
You'll freeze it right there. We'll move the freeze bar over. That becomes a new base card. You've kept Mark away from his cards. And the next question goes to you, Susan. We asked 100 college girls on the UCLA campus, at some point in your life, would you like to have a child? How many college girls said yes, they would?
100.
100. That was the
100.
Obstetrician out of the audience who said that.
I'm going to say 92.
92. I think most women would.
I think most women want to have children, yeah.
You want to have children?
Yeah, sometimes.
Mark, higher or lower than 92 want to have a child?
Well, with so many women starting jobs these days, I'm going to have to say lower.
You say lower.
Lower.
Yeah. All right, got some agreement out there from some of the women in the audience. The actual number of college girls who said they would like to have a child is 90.
All right.
Just a little bit lower, but it is lower. Mark, we'll look at your base card for this game. You have an eight. Ooh, do you want to play that or change it?
I'd like to change it.
Don't even have to ask. You'll change it. You've got to play this one. It is a four. Pretty good card.
Okay.
What's going to be?
Jim, I'll say the next card is higher, please.
Higher than a four. It is a jack.
Okay.
Good card.
Okay.
Now what's your decision?
Next card, lower.
Going to continue lower than a jack. It's a king, not lower. You lose both of those cards, and you're giving Susan a free play at her cards. You cannot change the six. You must play it. Call this card, Susan.
I'll call it higher.
Higher than a six. It's an 8. Okay. Well, Susan, you're right up the middle with the 8. You need only one card to win. What's it going to be? Freeze or try to turn it over?
I'm a chicken.
You're a chicken. You'll freeze it right there, needing one card. Janice, if you will, fill in the spaces. We'll go to the next question to you, Mark.
Okay.
We asked 100 Playboy bunnies, did you go to church last Sunday? Oh, you didn't think that, did you? How many said yes?
Playboy bunnies. I have to say 25 Playboy bunnies.
25. He thinks 25 Playboy bunnies went to church last Sunday.
I'm going
to
say lower.
You say lower than
that.
Don't have a lot of faith in the church-going ability.
No.
The actual number of Playboy bunnies who said they went to church last Sunday is 6.
Ah.
It is lower indeed. Susan, now you can change that 8 if you'd like.
Definitely. I'm going to change it, please.
All right. Here comes the all-important card for you. It is a 4. Susan, call this card correctly, and we have a tie match. What's it going to be?
Higher, please.
If this is higher, you've won the game, and we've got a tie match at 1-1. Higher than a 4, it's a
cat.
You did it. 1-1. That's $100 for Susan. Mark's got 100. Someone's going to get a chance at the money cards and a possible win of over $28,000. Right after this, clear the board, Janice. And we're back, as you can plainly see. We have a tie. Each player has one game at $100. Janice, if you will, load in the cards for the tie-breaking game. And there are just 3 cards up there for each player for the tiebreaker. So someone's going to get a chance at the money cards very quickly. Control of the board, most important with just those 3 cards. Susan, the question goes to you. We asked 100 men in a California studio audience, who is the boss in your home, you or your wife? How many men said their wife is the boss? That's tricky. 2, said somebody.
I don't know how many men would want to admit it. I'd say maybe
29
men would say their wife.
She says 29 men say the wife is the boss. Mark, higher or lower?
I think the man's the boss in most households. I'll have to say lower.
You say they'll say lower.
Lower.
The actual number of men who said their wife is the boss is 27. It is lower. Mark, you've got that all-important control. Just 3 cards up here for the tiebreaker. We'll take a look at that base card for you. It is a 7. You want to play that or change it?
I'd like to change it, please.
Here's the next card off the top of the deck, and these are the same decks throughout the match. It is a queen. Just 2 cards to go, Mark. Call them right, and you go to the money cards. What's
Jim,
your call here?
Lower, please.
Lower than a queen. It is an 8. Ooh, there's a big break for Susan, who gets a look at her base card here. It is a jack. You can't change it. Susan, what's
your call?
I'm
going to go lower.
You say lower than a jack. It is a 3. It is very much lower. Susan, 1 card gets you to the money cards with the win. But if you're wrong, then Mark is still in it. You can freeze it. What's your decision?
No, I'm going to go all the way. I'm going to say higher.
Higher. If this is higher than a 3, we have our first champion on Card Sharks. Higher than a 3 for the win. It's a 2. And a fine win it is. Congratulations, Susan. Good job. Mark?
Thanks.
You got done in by that 8.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Thank you very much.
You've got $100 for winning the game. You've got some nice parting gifts,
too.
Thank you, Mark. Susan, come on down here with me. Let you take a rest. You're not nervous, are you? The money card's coming up with a possible win of over $28,000 right after this. Good job.
How do you...
This is an exciting moment. Our first champion, first chance at the money cards. You're getting the giggles on me now, Susan.
I'm so excited.
That's nice. That's good. Well, listen, let's get to it then. Let's open the board and here come the money cards. Okay, Susan, come on up here. Now, here's how we play the money cards. You have $200 for winning the game. That's yours to keep. Now, we've got a brand new deck, and we're going to give you some new money to play with. And this time, you're going to bet that money. We'll start you on the bottom line with $200. Bet that as you wish on these 3 cards. When you move up to the second level, we add another $200 of betting money, and that you can bet as you wish as well. $50 minimum bets until you get to that top card, that big bet. And there, you must bet at least half the dollars. Now, it can really add up. You know how much it can add up to. It can add up to $28,800, as a matter of fact, if you do it. And I hope you do it, Susan. Come on. Good luck.
Thank you.
We'll start you with $200 right here. As always, a choice of 2 base cards. Let's Let's get a two or an ace, and we'll get my microphone over here. Here we go. It is a three. Yeah, good card to start right. with. Okay. You want to play that, or you want to change it?
Yes, I do. I'm going to bet
All right, you've got the $200. Okay. So just let me clarify for you. $200 and a three. What's your bet?
I'm going to bet $200 that the next card is higher.
And again, as in the game, if it's another three you lose, it must be higher than a three. For $200, higher than a three. Come on. It is a 10. That's higher. $400. That's the way to do it. You've got a 10. What's your bet on this card?
I'm going to bet $200 that the next card is lower.
Lower than a 10 for $200. We have
a jack.
Not lower. You lose that 200, but you've still got 200 and a good card here with the jack. What's your bet on this card?
I'm going to bet $200 that the next card is lower.
All right, let's get back in it. The whole yep. thing. Lower than a jack. It's a two. Yeah, and a great card. You've got $400. You have a great card, the two. We're going to move it up here and add another $200 of betting money. Susan, you have $600 uh-huh. and a two. What's your bet here?
I'm going to bet $600 that the next card is higher.
You ever bet $600 before, Susan?
No, I never have.
All right, good luck. Higher than a two, $600. It's an eight. $1,200. Kind of a tricky card there, the eight, Susan. What's your decision on this card?
I'm going to bet $50 that the next card is lower.
All right, that's not a bad strategy. Let's see if we can get a better card with a $50 bet. What did you say, higher?
I said lower.
Lower, okay. Yeah. Lower than an eight for $50. It's a 10. You had good intuition there. You only lost $50. You still have $1,150 and a better card, a 10. What's your bet here?
I'm going to bet $150, the next card lower.
Lower than a 10 for $150. It's a 5, yes. $1,300 as we move the 5 up for the big bet. Susan, you must bet at least $650. You can bet more if you like. You have $1,300. What's your bet?
I'm going to bet $700 that the next card is higher.
$700. You'll have $600 or you'll have $2,100 if this is higher than a 5. $700 higher than a 5. It is. Oh, it's a 2.
Oh, well.
But you've still got $600, Susan. That's not bad at all. Come on down here. $200 for winning the game. That's $800. She's the champion. Maybe we'll get another crack at the money cards. We'll find out. Right now, we're going to take time out for this, so please don't go away. Well, Susan, that big bet kind of did you in there, but you still have $800, $600 for the money cards and $200 for winning the match. You ready to meet new challenges?
I sure am.
All righty. Janice, if you'll start dealing out the cards now for the next match, two new decks for this match as we welcome our next challenger on Card Sharks. Hello there, Ray Ussery. Ray, nice to have you here with us, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Glad to be here.
Should I ask you what you do for a living?
I don't think so. I'm a warrant officer in the United States Navy. I'm originally from the state of Georgia. I'm father of four. I'm presently live and stationed in San Diego, California.
We're delighted to have you here with us. Let's get into
much.
The match very quickly. You have the lower cards, the blue cards, Ray. Susan, the champion, will play the red cards, and we'll start with a high-low toss-up question for you, Susan. We asked 100 women in the audience of the Carol Burnett Show in Hollywood, have you ever dreamed you were making love to Robert Redford? How many admitted they had?
I'd say 21.
She says
women.
21 women have admitted it. Ray, what do you say, higher or lower?
I don't think specifically Robert Redford. I think the number is actually lower.
You say lower. The actual number of women who confess they dreamed of making love to Robert Redford is 18. It is lower. Ray, you've got control of the board. And the first look at your base card, which is a queen.
Right.
You want to play that or you want to change it?
I'll play that one.
Then is this next card higher or lower?
The next card is definitely higher. Lower.
Okay. Don't be nervous, Ray. Lower than a queen. It is a 5, and it is lower. You can freeze if you'd like, or you can continue.
Oh, I think I'll press on. I think the next card will be higher.
Higher than a 5. It is a 6. A little bit higher. Getting near that middle, Ray. What's your decision
now? Freeze.
You're going to freeze it right there. We'll move that base card over. That becomes your new base card, the 6. We can't take that away from you. You've kept Susan away from the cards, and we've about run out of time there. We're off and running with a good match here, Ray and Susan. Susan, a good day for you with $800. And Ray, I hope you'll do well. And I thank you so much for joining us. You're two nice people. It's nice to meet nice people on the show. And it's nice to have nice people meeting us at home. So do come back and join us again the next time we play Card Sharks. Bye-bye. Ray?
Ever see the look on someone's face who's just won $100,000? You want drama? Watch this game show, The $100,000 Pyramid with Dick Clark, weekdays at 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. Eastern.